myself of the stuff that I have been dipped in, quadruped in, tripled in, doubled in. Because when I came to God, it was not because I hated sin. And some stuff I still like. And many times I wish the Bible would go away. Sometimes, because when you start calling people around and you start asking, did you hear what was preached on Sunday? What do you think about what the pastor said? And then you call somebody and they say, well, I believe it. You call somebody else. And we have a tendency to call around until we get somebody who agrees. Take all of that, only to find that you can't walk outside the principles of God and have the blessings of God to fall. Because if I walk outside of His principles, I'm going to walk with the consequences following. And then when the consequences start following, the only person I'll call is the one who said the Bible was right. I can call the rest to pray for me because they're in the same shape I am. I have to call the one who stood up on the principle and ask them to restore me to the grace of the living God. I feel something in me. I'm telling you, touch your neighbor after a while, but only five times tonight. It's a critical thing here because now He brings us into the battle and He points out to us that we are really wretched and only God through Jesus Christ can deliver us from the body of this death. He picks up an eight now, and eight is the place of the conclusion of His presentation of the gospel. And what He does in 8 is He declares, there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ Jesus. And the adjectival clause is who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. He did not divide the church into two groups, one that walks after the flesh and one that walks after the Spirit. He did not do that, no matter what they try to say. What He says is He takes the adjectival clause to describe those who are in Christ Jesus. And the adjectival clause is who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. And what He's saying is anybody who is in Christ Jesus does not walk after the flesh, but they walk after the Spirit. Which means it doesn't matter what your level of maturity is. If you keep on walking, you will metamorphosize into what God intends for you. Because the attitude of the child of God is not to live in self-condemnatory arenas when you're struggling to become what God would have you to become. Because the reason you struggle is because you are saved. Because there was a time when you wouldn't struggle at all. If you thought it, you would just do it. But now that you have been filled with the power of the Holy Ghost, there is a fight from the Spirit to control the attitudes of the flesh. There were times when I would have walked out, but the Holy Spirit grabbed me and said, you're going to stay here until you put the enemy under your feet. I'm almost there. It is It's here when we understand then that the sufferings within the context of expectation becomes critical now, because all of us are suffering, looking at who we are and looking at what God intends for us to be. And so what the writer points out then is that there is a glory inside of us that can only be released by our present suffering. It is a glory that is there that people on the outside don't always see, because they don't know the power that resides on the inside. The phenomenology of power is seen here, because I remember John just went straight to the point as opposed to Paul. John simply said, in spite of your struggles, greater is he that's in you than he that is in the world. The people around me only see me in light of my circumstance. But what they don't know is that in the middle of my circumstance, I can project myself into my future. Even though it looks like I am being enveloped and overwhelmed by what I'm in, you don't have the power to see that I am in here, but my spirit is already expecting. Oh, I feel some pushing in there. It's critical, because the greater relates to the controlling force of my environment, because my environment has great effect. I am not dealing now with the environment being weak. No, I'm dealing with the environment being great. But greater is in me. So no matter how rough it is on the outside, I know that my inside has the capacity to outdo whatever's on the outside. It's great, because even though I'm crying, I'm not finished yet. The great makes me cry, but the greater keeps me while I am crying. The great may hurt me, but the greater gives me comfort in the middle of the pain. The great may lose my job, but the greater gives me joy in spite of the loss. My circumstance comes and goes, but my spirit stays at the same. That's what I can declare. In spite of what I'm going through, I will bless the Lord. It is this power of expectation. It is this ability now to bring yourself through the present because of future perspective.